Anybody out there drinking that Walmart coffee? I'm just saying. So, I did a video a couple weeks ago. Went to a Danzig show and somehow got like 12,000 views off of this one video on a performer that I was not the performer. Danzig was the performer. Well, we got a lot of Danzig fans out there, apparently. I never knew. Anyway, I have been a MacBook / iOS fool for about 4 years now. Learned a lot of things. Thank you, YouTube. And I got a video. Well, it's not really Mac, but it's more like T-Mobile. But I got this video that I wanted to do. And so we're doing it today. That's what we're doing. I'm also going to slip in some MacBook stuff because I'm a dope fiend for MacBooks. Here we go. And Danzig. I'm a dope fiend for Danzig too, as you can see. Thank you very much. So this is the T-Mobile home router. It's got a button in the center. It's got a button on the side and a button on the other side. Says your connection is very good. That's awesome. If I put the router in a different place, it would pick up the signal from the sky or wherever it comes from better. But it's pretty good. And then it distributes the signal throughout the house well enough. Any problems with it? It says 5G. Tells you the time in case you didn't like have a clock on your phone. I don't know why. And then it's got a couple of ports on the back. It's got Ethernet port, and then it's got that's the plug to power it, and then that's a USB-C, like the oval one, the newer style, not the old style. And that's it. It's got this supposed to be for a SIM card. I don't know how you could screw with that to take that out or mess with that or even why you would, but that's it. T-Mobile, home internet. It just has a problem connecting to the older hardware, and even T-Mobile will tell you that, but there is a way you can do it, and I'm about to show you. This is the Apple TV, third generation. This has got the older USB. This is the USB that you're gonna need, the older style. You're gonna plug it into the Apple TV right there, underneath the HDMI port. And then you're gonna plug the other part, the other end, into your MacBook or your PC. You can do this with a Windows computer. From what I hear, it takes a little time sometimes for it to pop up, but you can see mine popped up. So we're gonna restore Apple TV. What's that say? Restore and update. Next. Agree. I'm not gonna read none of that. So what happened with this Apple TV is I tried to jailbreak it. I think I used a rain check one or something like that. It didn't work, obviously. And so, I'm going to restore it and we'll see what happens. I don't know how long this says 3 minutes, 2 minutes remaining. I'm not going to hold you hostage. Okay, here we go. Apple TV recovery mode. Your Mac is restoring the software on this Apple TV. You can do this.
I don't know how that's done, but I found something.
Hey, Google, shut the fuck up. Man. Okay, so you can't do this on a Windows computer. And I don't know how, but I have done it on a Windows computer before. I haven't done it in Linux, but I have done it on Windows before. So this is going to take a little while longer, it looks like. Actually. I'm gonna show y'all that I'm not a big baller shot caller. Go to about this Mac and I'm gonna show you what this Mac is. It's running Ventura 13.5.2, 2.5 gigahertz dual core Intel Core i5 with Intel HD 4000 graphics. I did put 16 gigabytes of RAM in it that I got off Amazon for about $20. Running Ventura. Do more info. I'll show you what year this computer is. System report. Let's try system report. Okay, there we go. That's what I'm looking for. Can I blow this up? Yes, I can. Well, not much. So, MacBook Pro 9.2. 9.2 is a 2012. And we're still restoring the software on this Apple TV. But I wanted to show you that this is an older MacBook from 2012 running Ventura through something called OpenCore Legacy Patcher. And if you have an older MacBook, you can't get the newest apps. You can get the newest apps if you run OpenCore Legacy Patcher. Okay, so it's really easy to install now. It used to be harder to install. Your Apple TV has been restored to factory settings. Please disconnect your Apple TV from your Mac and reconnect it to your TV. So we're going to say okay. And then we're going to disconnect. I hope you like feet. So here we go. We got the T-Mobile router. I got 13 devices connected. That means my Apple TV is not connected. I've got a regular old cable connected to the Apple TV. HDMI cable is connected to the TV. And of course the power cord. So I've got the Apple remote, third generation. So you don't point it at the TV, you gotta point it at the Apple TV, and it's gotta be facing the front, because the Apple TV is an infrared IR, so it's not like a Wi-Fi remote, it's an IR remote. There we go, English. We're gonna continue. You can help Apple TV. I'd rather not help Apple TV. It's the third generation. They don't support it. There's no new software. So why should we give them any details? They're not gonna listen. I mean, it's third generation. Most of these apps aren't even gonna work. So let's go to settings. We're gonna go to network. Time zone, I'm not in Cupertino. Okay, let's do off. Yeah, now we can select the time zone. Alright, let's okay. Okay, here we go. So, arrange main menu items. Now, I'd rather not. So, let's see. I don't think Netflix works. Alright, let's try to share from the iPad. So, I can't find the phone. Alright. Screen sharing on the iPad. Okay. So, here we go. You see that? Yeah, screen sharing on my iPad. Let's try that. Apple TV. Can you see that? Apple TV. Bam. Okay. So, now let's watch some YouTube. Oh, dancing. If you're a subscriber, you probably know that I really do like dancing a whole lot. Let's go ahead and watch this Long Way Back from Hell. Because it really is a long way back from hell. Do you really want to cross that line? I don't think you do. That's a pretty good image.
YouTube. Let's search for some movie on YouTube.
See, I used to use Tubi, and you can put Tubi on your iPhone or whatever else you got. I don't know if you can share Netflix. Netflix is kind of messed up about screen sharing. I just searched for movies on YouTube.
Twilight Zone movie. That's an awesome movie.
I don't know if y'all ever seen this before. It's on the TV. On the iPad, it's just connected to AirPlay. I twist, drive, or. So let's go to YouTube settings. It will change the video quality. Well, it's already on 720p. Let's see how this does. You wake up in the morning. See? 720p. Probably as good as it is. It's a good TV, too. And I march you to the table. You see the same old thing. Ain't no food upon the table. There's no fork up in the pan. But you better not complain, boy. You get in trouble with the man. So I just went back to menu. So what I'm about to do right here is I am going to unplug the T-Mobile router from Apple TV. So it's just Apple TV, T-Mobile router without the cable to the router. Right. So we're gonna go down to, we're gonna go to General. We're gonna go to Network. We're gonna see if we see anything. So we got Wi-Fi. It says here, no, we don't have Wi-Fi. Your Apple TV isn't connected to a network. To use Apple TV, join a Wi-Fi or Ethernet network. Okay. You can see that? I don't want you to think I'm lying to you. Yeah, your Apple TV isn't connected to a network. It tells us that the third generation Apple TV won't connect to a network. Well, let's try. So these are my neighbor's networks. So this is my T-Mobile 5G/2.4. And it's supposed, the T-Mobile is supposed to let it connect whatever it connects to. Whatever it can connect to. Let's see if it'll connect. Okay, this is what happens. I've got a first generation iPad. And it won't let me put a password into my first generation iPad either. This is the T-Mobile thing that it just doesn't work. So we're going to go back to menu, like it says. This is my other T-Mobile network. Now this network is a 2.4 network. Other words, I'm going to put the password in, close your eyes. Here, I'll help you because I know you weren't going to do it on your own. So, I did get connected to my network, to my 2.4 network, which is awesome. I call it other words. In other words, okay, now we're good. Now let's see. Was it Red Bull? Red Bull was the only thing that would play? Maybe.
2 p.m. at Red Bull
Station. Yeah, baby! Being a part all right, of this, so here we go. I'm going to show you one more time. So I'm not connected with the Ethernet cable anymore. See, I just got the power cord plugged in. Got nothing else going on.
The T-Bridge, and from here you can.
Apple TV. All I got here.
Wow.
Is an HDMI and power cord. Just look at the T-Mobile app. It goes with your T-Mobile home internet. So you're gonna go to network. So whatever you got set up for your network, like when you first get it set up, it's gonna have two right? It's gonna say 2.4 and 2.5, and then you're gonna set up another network, right? So to set up another network that's gonna be just your 2.4 for your older hardware, you're gonna press that plus button, and then it's gonna ask you to set up a Wi-Fi network name with a Wi-Fi network password, and then you're gonna come down here and you're gonna select whether you want it to be a 2.4 or a 5G, right? Well, you're gonna select 2.4 so that you can connect your older devices to it. For example, I had to do this just the other day so that I could hook up this old printer that would not connect to a 5G network. It's a Canon Pixma. It wouldn't connect to the 5G network on the T-Mobile home internet, and so I had to set up this other 2.4 network for it. So you can do that with the T-Mobile thing, so that you can have two different networks. One's dedicated to 2.4G, and the other one is 2.4 or 5G, depending on what the, see, it says automatic, so like maybe the device will accept a 5G, maybe the device will run on 5G. If it'll run on 5G, then it'll run on 5G. If it can't run on 5G, it'll run on 2.4. But some of them, the older ones, like the first generation iPad, the third generation Apple TV, and this old ass printer, they won't like figure out which one to connect to. And so you have to set up a totally different network and make it 2.4 gigahertz so that it can connect to it. That's all there is to that.
So this is the first generation iPad that I was talking about earlier? Okay. So you just got the 30-pin connector. So here's my Felonious Punk. This is my 5G / 2.4. We're going to try to connect to it, and it's not going to connect. Gonna ask me for a password, right? So I'm gonna put the password in. Right now we're gonna do join, and it's not gonna join. It never does. And it says incorrect password for Felonious Punk. But it is a correct password. It does that every time I try to do that. It just says that it's the incorrect password, even though I have put the correct passwords in. So we're gonna go to the other words, which is the strictly 2.4. And we're gonna enter the password. Okay, so I just put the password in, and I'm gonna hit join. And let's see if it'll connect. Well, let's see. Yep, it connected. So the older hardware will connect to the T-Mobile router if you have simply a 2.4 network set up separately from your 2.4/5 gig network. It will connect. Not that you can do anything with this ancient iPad. So I did go to Reddit, and I read about how to do the 2.4 gigahertz network on the T-Mobile router. I haven't seen any YouTube, so I made one, and I hope this helps somebody.